6,500 pounds, the newly revised half-ton towable 26V impact toy hauler here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. This is a floor plan we have not brought in previously for the sole reason that the garage was too small. It was kind of crappy. And I was chatting with the brand manager down at Impact, and they said, you know, other manufacturers build these 25, 26 foot no slide half ton towable toy haulers and they do well with them. What are we missing? And it used to be that the refrigerator was on the door side of the RV inside just behind that entry door. And what that meant was you had this like crappy 7.5, 8 foot garage that just wasn't good for loading anything really. And I said, you know, if you move that refrigerator over toward the kitchen and open up the whole side of the camper on the door side, you'll get more room for seating, more room for windows, and more room for loading. And they listened, and suddenly I think we've got ourselves a stone cold stunner of a model here. Before we hop inside, I wanted to take a look at this full retractable rolled down screen wall. It's just a lot simpler and easier to use. It's a lot faster as compared to the tent screen walls when it's time to roll them up. The tent screen walls are nice for windbreakers. They have their own set of advantages, but I think a lot of people prefer this because it's an easy, obvious bug screen with no sort of gaps on the side. And again, when it is time to roll it away, you can just flick your toe on the handle and lift it up with your hand, no sweat. Now, what I'm about to show you is going to look insane, but don't have a heart attack and hear me out. This RV has a Happy Jack power lift system in the back here, which is normal in toy haulers. However, they did a very classic thing, and I wanted to make sure it did not go unnoticed. They gave it a rear-facing sofa so that the outside patio area actually has a really cool seating arrangement to it. Now, normally, the sofa would not be sitting 4 feet in the air. You absolutely, positively can bring it down to normal seating height. But of course, you can also fold it down into a bonus sleeping space as well. So it never loses any function or feature. It gives you just a different level and different type of flexibility from what you commonly see in most toy haulers. But that's what I like about this one. It's not the common toy hauler. And this right here, this new, bigger, wide open loading space, that's what got me excited about this one. You can see where that TV hutch is. That used to basically be where it stopped because the refrigerator was directly across from it. Well, that didn't leave enough room to actually be able to load anything in here. So they said, you know what? We'll listen to you. We'll take your advice. We'll move that fridge. And now suddenly, bam, we got this big wide open loading space. Now, like a big fifth wheel, you can see this is dovetailed for easy loading. And this has the same 5K interlocking tie-down system of the Big Brother Impact fifth wheel series. Every single one of these tie-downs that you see, of which there are 8 in here, they are actually directly reinforced straight into the frame with a, it looks like, I call it waffle style construction because there's so many crisscross applesauce members giving you all sorts of structural integrity through here. They actually hooked up a giant razor to one of their floors, flipped the whole chassis upside down, and the thing held. It just suspended there, hanging in midair. Somebody had to have pretty big confidence in this to literally hang a razor from thin air, but they did so successfully. Now, it is nice also that it is completely carpetless. Now, there's going to be a couple different entertainment arrangements that you can get out of this one, and we'll actually come back to that in a little bit. But for now, I just want you to take note of the fact that the TV is in a better position than most toy haulers. A lot of toy hauler travel trailers, first of all, they don't include a TV. And if they do, it's, I don't know, cheap little Chinese legend type thing. And it'll be mounted, like, way up here where you have to do a total neck cramp situation to try to get into it, like it's 1985 and I'm a kid playing Nintendo neck again. Well, you don't have that issue over here, and you do have a Bluetooth DVD stereo system on this, and I do like that they left it up high enough where it's not going to like interfere with wheel wells or anything like that. But really, the loading space, the living space, those are nice, but what kind of took it over the top for me was the really impressive amount of kitchen storage that you have in here. Starting up here above the entertainment center, what's nice, all hardwood cabin door frames, and by the way, let's talk about the decor. They went very modern, very residential in their color package. And this is going to be polarizing, but I think a lot more people are going to like it than dislike it. Because it seems like for the longest time, toy haulers have looked like barbed wire and blow torches and you know, chain link fence. You don't have that here. This just has a nice living room look and feel. And lighter feels brighter feels bigger, and bigger feels better. It just has a modern, classy look, feel, and edge to it, and I like that. But back to the cabinetry. It's all pocket screwed, longer lasting, and you'll see that all the cabinet doors, they are hidden hinges, and your upper doors are still strutted to keep themselves open, as we're seeing right here. So those are some of those higher class features that you will expect to find here. Because like I said, there are other brands that build similar floor plans. Why would you go with the Impact version versus something else? And it's 100 fine little details. Like the fact that the refrigerator, it's magnet friendly. We've got an 8 cubic foot gas electric traveling refrigerator. And now that it's over here with the rest of the kitchen, like I said, it opens up the rest of the RV so that all of this, what used to be lost floor space, but no longer. Now this is the RV I think it always should have been. But maybe I'm biased. Well, the proof, the time will tell, you know, whether it sells or not. That will really be the telling indicator. But I think we've got an RV here that's got the best chance of selling compared to the previous years. You may have also noticed no heat vents in the floor, which I think is really smart in a toy hauler where you have tires that can be dropping all kinds of God knows what or running over vents. This makes more sense. Plywood box drawers, more of that hidden hinge cabinetry. They opened up every little nook and cranny they possibly could. Now, down here, down in that area right there, there's a little silver switch, like a little plunger switch. That's an easy reach battery disconnect. And I love its location. You can hop in, activate or kill the battery real quickly and easily. But it's also inside the RV where it's protected so that if the RV's in storage, somebody else can't activate your battery and drain it for you. Great counter space here. And look at those easy reach appliance outlets. Isn't that a nicer, smarter feature? The overhead cabinet capacity in this is fantastic. The fact that they put shelves in this, because not only is the ceiling extra tall, but they maximized your capacity by adding an extra shelf in there. Now, let me take a step back here, just because above this big campsite viewing window, you've got all of this extra storage capacity here as well. So there's, you know, never an ounce of space going to waste in this thing, especially as high as this is. It won't interfere with like razor roll cages or anything like that. And what's cool about this, that window looks right out under your awning so that you can see what's going on your campsite. But that's kind of one of the neat things with toy haulers. You tend to get a lot of windows over here so that you can see what's happening under your awning instead of only looking at the neighbors. But nope, man, they were generous with the appliance outlets in this thing. There's a lot of copper in this camper. Wider 30-inch entry door, and take note that inside the door is another full viewing window. It does also have a privacy shade. It's funny because it says thin shade ready, but it's actually installed, not just ready. So, moving over here to the bedroom and the bathroom. This is where, you can start to see that modern sort of color combination. Very, like, if you go into home designs right now, this is a lot of what you're seeing. And it was a very bold, risky decision they made because the RV business tends to be very conservative. But recently here, in recent years, we've seen people buck that trend and say, I don't care. I want what's new. I don't want what looks like 10 years old. This looks like, or my favorite phrase is, it looks like my grandpa's camper. Oh, that'll just disappoint you. Now, because this is a true toy hauler, it's got the extra wide body, the extra tall ceiling. That means that you've got the shower fit for an NBA center. Shaquille O'Neal, hop on in this thing. You are not going to hit your head. It'll give you a nice place to get in there and wash off the icy hot that you use to keep those aches and pains down to a minimum, at least according to your commercials. Another thing that's nice, you get out of the shower, or if you're on this nice porcelain foot floor stool, you've actually got some leg room and some foot room where you can get dressed in here without having to go traipsing through the whole RV. Now, neat thing on Keystone RVs is like their doorways, they're fully framed and studded out so that it retains a square shape and the door doesn't pop open and bang around in transit. Neat little detail that I almost missed when I first walked in here is the fact that you have an easy reach light switch, because these lights are anything but easy to reach. So those big main cabin lights that are nice and bright, you don't have to be a football player or a basketball player to reach those things, or, you know, a person with a ladder. Up here, we do have a vent for some extra light and airflow here in the bedroom, and that shiplap accent front wall is something that I, like, every single person, that's one of those 10 out of 10 people have gone, yeah, I like that. That looks good. 60 by 80, true residential queen bed. And what that means is that you've got extra room in a wide body RV to really walk around this thing. And you can see you've got those nice wide open side stands. But look at the fine little details here. Like the fact that these hanging closets have radius edged corners. They have them fully finished out So that one, you don't see any raw underbelly construction on those things, but two, you no longer have those annoying sharp pointed edges jabbing you in the shoulder when you roll over. And what's also nice is they really finished the job out. They've done a lot of nice detail-oriented things, and they stuck with it by giving you an easy lift plywood bed, or bed decking, rather, here in the bedroom area. Now, I mentioned how we'd come back to the entertainment center. Pardon me as I spin you right round, baby. But here you can see how that TV can swing right out for easy viewing. And where that's really nice is if you decide you want to take advantage of these dual, full, free-floating, easy swivel, lightweight Euro recliners that you can option into the Impact 26V like you're seeing here on this one. Remember, the one in stock might be a little different, but it gives you that perfect little entertainment station where you can kick your feet up, or if you want, you could always take these things out on the patio deck and just really be able to kick back in comfort and style. Now, we can certainly find you less expensive, similar size toy haulers. You're going to be giving up some features. Like, this is very similar to a Jayco Octane 273. It's very similar to a Wolfpack 24 Pack 14 Plus. But this is kind of, in a sense, the upscale version of it. You know, it's all laminated, aluminum skeleton type work, you know, made to be something a little higher end in terms of look, feel, and appointments. Like, you saw the backside of the heat shielding for the generator prep. That's another feature that we kind of suggested to him. We said, you know, when you're in a toy hauler, I don't care if it's your more basic toy hauler, like the Impact Vaporlight series is for the Fusion and Impact family, like you're looking at right here. People are expecting it to be able to accommodate a generator. So they made that happen. And that's what I like about these guys. They're very willing to do what needs to be done, and they do it so well. We have a not just wide body, but a matching wide chassis for structural integrity and stability. Of course, power awning, power tongue jack, things like that that you expect. What is also nice here is something that you can't see, and that is the quality of construction and precision that goes into this. Like the sidewalls here, they are fully CNC machine routed. They're not hand routed wall and window cuts. That means that you just have ultra precision where you have the most critical seams of the RV. And then you notice they're also using frameless windows, which is a little more of a, gives it a bit of an upscale look, but also very rainy day friendly. So here's a look at the generator prep station. You can have a factory generator installed on this RV. However, we found at this size and category, there's a lot of people still looking for one without. If your interest is an onboard generator, well, give us a call at Halet RV. We can take care of that for you, too. Neat little thing they did over here right next to your dump station is you actually have a hideaway outside shower type thing. So there's a little blue coily hose that comes with this thing if you want to hose off your, you know, your bikes or your quads or whatever you got. You got a perfect little spot to do that right there. Actually, I like how a lot of your connections, like the key TV connection, the water connection, all that stuff is sort of hidden away. And these radial wheels, they just, they got like a pretty rugged sort of look to them with what looked to be sort of like bead protecting rings on the inside. It's mostly just visual, by the way. Now, this does have a 30-gallon fuel station on it. The actual fueling station is on the other side of the RV. That is simply the fuel inlet right there. We've got all LED tail and marker lights, and you also have backup lighting when you shift into reverse. Lights overhead the toy hauler gate area will ignite, and those things are bright. So especially if you you do want to see if you are backing up, if you got a spotter at night, you've got a perfect place for it. The patio party deck that we're looking at is an optional piece of equipment that we like to apply to these. It obviously just extends your living space quite a bit. And it is rated for 3,000 pounds loading and 1,500 pounds in the party position as you see it here. Now, those are pretty normal weight ratings, but I found that a lot of dealers and a lot of consumers don't know what those ratings are, so I like to make sure I take a moment to share that with you. They put a pretty darn generous awning on this thing as well, and although it doesn't look like it at a glance, it's actually the biggest awning you possibly could put on this RV. You're looking at it thinking, yeah, there's a lot of empty wall in front of it, but the wall tapers down in the bedroom area. So they gave it the maximum length that possibly could before the taper there. Now there is LED lighting below that. Whoops, oh, my power button. Sorry about that. I'm not really sure where that took place. Anyway, hopefully didn't miss anything. The fuel station, here's where the actual mechanism and handle and dispensing location is. Then there's a little emergency kill switch in here. Like, let's just say, God forbid, something crazy happens and you got fuel spilling out, you can hit the kill switch and disengage that pump. One other thing that I want to point out here before we wrap things up is the latch system that they have on the ramp door itself. They're actually using a positive latch system here that you can padlock it if you want, but it does have its own key lock system as well. So it's just a little bit more secure. Plus, when you're pulling the ramp door down, it actually gives you like a nice big handle to hold on to. And you might notice how down here there is a pretty hefty spring assist system. So you don't have to be a big muscle-bound lug to be able to lift that thing up and down. I think that pretty much gets us, guys. So I'd be, like I said, really curious. I'd love some feedback as to what you think about the interior of that RV. And give us a call. If this one looks like it'll work, let's put it together. Doesn't matter where you live. They're on wheels. We make deals happen. Probably because we just do everything here at Haylett RV. Hitching, pieces, parts, trades, finance, truck and trailer package deals, RV delivery, and everything in between. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone. And remember, we don't do hidden dealer fees here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan.